distinguished and respected guests and speakers. I am very much privileged to talk about this blockchain technology, particularly with respect to the agriculture implementation point of view. To be frank, I am not that much knowledgeable person. What I know, I can deliver something about this blockchain technology, because this is a very much baby infant stage, this blockchain technology introduced to India itself. Maybe it has been brought long back through Satoshi, through Bitcoin introducing. So they have taken this back-end technology for other purposes from so many organizations like Ethereum, Ripple, or so many other IBM, Linux, so many open source technology organizations. They have taken this as a base of this technology for financial and non-financial transactions also. So we need not worry about that we have to do the financial transaction. This can be happily introduced with non-financial transactions for any kind of our activities in our daily life. That much comfortability is there. So regarding this blockchain technology, when we are going to adopt, we have to be careful about that. This is not a single technology like that, just get it and implement or download into our system and do the work. Not like that. It will not work like that. It has some dependencies on other technologies and other stakeholders of this technology also. So when the blockchain technology we are going to, I want to introduce about this one. Why this? I have mentioned this Agri blockchain. When our people from FAPC has asked me to just deliver about something, from Kulkarni especially, he has pointed out me that, sir, you focus on agriculture mainly. So because I have worked with so many technology aspects implementing the blockchain with respect to the financial and non-financial also. I worked with the movie making also into the blockchain. I am the ambassador of India for the movie making through blockchains. And I have worked with the social media also. And I have worked with a token management system in the lending systems also implementing the blockchain technology. So I have worked with so many advisory companies where they are going for the ICOs. ICOs is nothing but initial coin offering, like our IPO, where we are going for the money in the for the public, to the public. Through ICO, they are going to get this money to do the projects in the blockchain. So that is called an ICO, funding to the blockchain projects through ICO. There they will give the coins instead of some currency or something, their coins, company coins. Later on, they have to exchange those coins in their particular coin exchanges to get the... So that is the ICO and blockchain technology perspective. But with respect to our country, there are so many regulations. Because the blockchain technology, as Rishikesh told, there are regulations issues are there. Because every country is not considering it is a financial transaction as a authenticated financial transaction. Because it is not an asset. So the through regulation as regulation conditions of the regulatory authorities of the each country, they will consider it as an asset, then it will be an issue. So through blockchain, they are telling that it is not an issue, asset. We can transfer the one asset to other person. Then we can do it freely. We need not pay any taxes or anything. It will be very free trade. So there are the issue in that. So many countries are not giving any free regulatory norms to do the transactions through blockchain, especially in the financial aspect. For the non-financial aspects, there is no issue at all. Regarding the point of this blockchain with respect to data and everything, this is a distributed ledger technology. So nothing but, as usual, we are working in our own offices and everything in RDBMS. Right, one server will be there, all are will be connected to the server, and the data will be stored in a single box, that is a server, and there we have to do the transaction by getting the permissions from the server and the administrator. But in this blockchain, what happens, all the data will be stored in the server, the same transactions of data will be stored in all participants in the blockchain. Okay, so the data will be stored in all the computers of the participants of the blockchain. So if one person's data has been hacked or the machine has been collapsed or something, the other person's data will be immediately copied into the network, through the network, and update in the system. So this will not be collapsed, and it can be hacked. But what is the use? Suppose there are 100 systems are there in the network, one system may be hacked and collapsed, there will not be any problem. Some other nodes will take care of that. It can be hacked because security is not that much 100% developed. So that's why hacking will be always there, but hashing will be there. Big why? Whatever the data, whatever the transaction in the ledger, who will put it? The transaction means whatever the instruction are written, or either sentence or image or transaction or numeric field, anything, whatever you enter in the blockchain server as a record, that will be the transaction. They will call it as a transaction. All the records, all the sentences, all the data will be considered as a records, and a total will be called as a ledger. All the ledgers will be put in a block, and all the blocks will be connected one by one with a reference address to first block, to second block, and third block, footer address and head of the address with hashing. With hashing, those things will be referenced with the next block. So every block will be chained with the previous block. If anybody tried to manipulate the data in the system and to try to push the data into the network, as it will not be considered, because it will be failed through getting the reference of the previous block, right? So automatically your block will not be considered by the other systems. Here, how you will get the authentication? You are the four people. You are using the blockchain network. You are the four people in the network. You four people are doing the transactions. Some fifth person, unknown person, has entered and hacked the fourth person's system, and he tried to put the data, but he has manipulated the data. It will not be connected to the whatever the blocks already used. Okay, that is one thing. And how this can be identified? Remaining these four nodes of your team members network will cross check the block data. Whatever the block data transactions, it will be broadcasted to all the network people, and all the people will have the mechanism to approve whether this data has been coming from authorized nodes of our friends in the network or not. They will verify. It will verify the address and authentication, because already this guy has pushed the other data, right? It will not have the connectivity data reference. Automatically, they will reject the data, reject that block. Automatically, it will be deleted. It will be cancelled. It will not be added into our blockchain. So that kind of security will be there through hashing and the mechanism of the approval, proof of state or proof of work. So there are so many mechanisms are there. To go get into the details of technical itself, it will become very tedious for you and may not be that much comfortable at this stage. And what I want to explain you on this, as a layman, I have prepared my presentation. I am very poor in creating the presentations, to be frank. I can speak something, but I cannot do the presentation. So please kindly bear with me whatever I have done. Within a short span, I could prepare this kind of stuff, and I want to present before all of you. Anybody else from the agriculture department? Any senior roles, any decision-making roles? Research? Thank you. Okay. Anybody from seed management, sir? Anybody from food processing industries? Oh, very nice. Very good, very good. Anybody from other kind of industries, any manufacturing? Manufacturing, very nice. Anybody from retail stores, malls, or any kind of thing? Okay, no problem. Anybody from education side? Oh, very nice. So many people are there. Okay, nice. Anyways, this is a good gathering, and I want to introduce about the agriculture concepts, how to adapt in this blockchain. Actually, I worked with so many banks earlier all over the world with respect to so many financial modules and everything. And I have worked with multiple domains with oil and gas and World Bank projects with respect to the agriculture and poverty elevations and education and most of them are financial side. So now I would like to introduce about this Agri blockchain. So actually, why do we need this blockchain? That is my first fundamental question I want to ask you all. Why do we need this blockchain? Everybody is talking about the blockchain, so let us have the blockchain in our company or in our organization. Let us. Is it crazy for us or what? Yes, most of them are correct. All of them are correct. Not most of them. All of them are correct. What Hrishikesh has also told, that so many features are there in the blockchain as per the technical perspective. Very much advantages are there. So these are all will be covered and available, and we can achieve through this implementation of this blockchain. Then I want to see some of the, what are the eligibility norms for this blockchain, and if we want to go for the blockchain, and what are the eligibility norms we have to see. Everybody cannot go for the blockchain. So we have to see what are the eligibilities we can, fundamental checks we have to do, and how to evaluate this feasibility. See, suppose we have the money or something, let us have the server and put it, okay, let us go, that company is doing the blockchain, we are also going for the blockchain, let us go. Not like that. How to evaluate the feasibility, whether it will be feasible or not, once we get into the blockchain. Let us see that. And some of the case studies, as a layman case studies from Raghu Kumar, I have designed something about the agriculture and food processing. Most of the people, you know about those processings, but with respect to the blockchain, how to do that, I want to just explore on those things. Is it fine? Thank you. So the major benefits, some of the points I have mentioned here, the burning topic in our country is the farmers issue. Most of the farmers are suiciding themselves because of bad crops, crop failures, crop debts, all these things, because calamities, because of the seed quality, because of the poor quality of the pesticides, whatever they are getting in the market. There is no guidance, there is no marketing facility, proper marketing facility, there is no correct price for their product from the market itself. There is no storage facility, there is no guidance, so there is no confidence at all among them. So this is the my main point, is that to save the farmers from crop failures and debts, this is the first fundamental issue I want to address, and improve the agriculture GDP of our country. Automatically this will, once we achieve that, automatically you know, all know that the GDP will be improved, and increase the employment in agriculture. So many of the people are now just turning to the agriculture side. Hope you know all that, whether so many IT people are getting group and they are buying the lands recently. Whether you know it or not, I don't know. So they are going for the group farming. They are looking for the best, implement the best methods in the farming itself. So Go Farmers, one of the group is there. Like that, they used to contact me so many times. So like that, we can get the increase of the employment in agriculture. There is guaranteed returns if we get the blockchain into the agriculture sector, and improve the living standards of the people. Automatically our living standards will be improved. When the income levels will become high, then automatically our living standards will be comfortable, and improve the food safety and health. Once the blockchain is also implemented in the agriculture sector in a proper way, and fruit processing industry also, then our quality of the food and definitely will be improved, and food safety norms we will meet as per the global standards, and automatically most of the health will be achieved by all the persons as per the standards, and improve the abundant income levels. Automatically income levels of the each person, his family will be, not only farmers, all the people will be improved. So why do we need the blockchain? My point is that why do we need the blockchain? As you all told, that to perform these activities with trust, reliability, time saving, cost saving, safety, transparency. These are the major things we can do, we can achieve through implementation of the blockchain technology. Okay? So when the trust means what? The blockchain technology will have some people, because what I told you is that blockchain will not be implemented by a single person. This is the network. Okay, when the people blockchain network, in that network, what is the network? That is a blockchain will be adapted for transforming our existing, our business process into the blockchain. Okay, when you are doing some business, you are sending some eggs to one person, every store or something, you have the poultry, you have the eggs and everything, but you are selling all those things to some stores in the Hyderabad or some any house, domestic also, then you have so many people, you have to depend on so many people to serve the, send these eggs to the destination. You have to open the platform, poultry, you have to get those eggs from the hen, and those eggs will be sorted out, will be packed, it will be shipped, it has to be delivered, it has, the money has to be collected back. In the meanwhile, so many damages also will be there. So many people's dependency is there. You alone cannot do that, the entire business process, right? So when you are going to introduce the blockchain and you want to adopt this blockchain and put your business process into blockchain, all these people's activities will be recorded as a data in the blockchain. Okay, so end customer, I will verify that your egg is as per the norms, laid as per the norms, and quality of the eggs and everything I can check as an end customer, and I will be a reliable customer for you. So the trust between you and me, that is, you are the producer, I am the consumer. So the trust will be happened through blockchain, and the reliability will be there automatically, and the time saving, because the time saving, when you are doing the business process, you have to depend on the people to serve their job immediately, or you have to wait for their job to their, for the completion. So suppose if you sell some product and everything, you have to wait for the money from the buyer. So for that, you have to depend on the banks, some of the intermediaries, some of the dealers, some of the distributors and everything, all the people has to collect, and finally you will get the money. Okay, but in this blockchain, you can eliminate all those intermediary people. You and the direct buyer can be contacted directly in the blockchain. So automatically the buyer will pay directly to you. Okay, so like that, there will be a facility and platform through the blockchain we can do by eliminating the intermediaries, unnecessary expenditures and everything. Like that, we can have the time saving, cost saving, and safety also. Whatever the data we are putting and the transactions, everything will be stored in a single place in a safety measures. And transparency, that is the main thing. Transparency is, everybody can see the transactions, what they have done as per their activities with hashing. Okay, so that transparency is there, for auditable is there. Tomorrow the data cannot be deleted. Once you entered the data or record or something, it will be stored permanently. You cannot delete it. If you want to put the right data, you have to retype the data, re-enter the data, write information into the system again. That will be stored again. So it will not be overwrite, it will not be deleted. So that kind of transparency will be there. You cannot delete it. Immutable, what I mean to say is immutable. So there are many benefits are there. So that's why we are trying to get this blockchain into our business. Then what are the basic eligibility? What I have discussed is that the consider the blockchain as a database, right? As a distributed ledger stored equally across network nodes, that is your participants in your total network, who are the, as a distributor, supplier, or somebody, anybody involved in dependency with your business, and need all business process stakeholder participation. Remember, you alone cannot do the business with a blockchain. You have to get the supply chain data, so your supply chain people's data also to be included in this blockchain, your distributors data to be included in this blockchain, your payments receives bank or something, that data also to be included in this blockchain. Everybody's data, everybody's stakeholders participation must be required in this blockchain. Otherwise you will have very much gap in this information. There is no purpose of using the blockchain. Okay, then all stakeholders, these are all called stakeholders, these stakeholders should share their corresponding business data with your blockchain network. Only your business data, not all their business data, not required. that privileges will be there. And assume transformation of business process into blockchain is collective decision of all its stakeholders, right? So this is the concept, what is the basic eligibility. Once we have to sit together, all our the people, our stakeholders in our company, these are the things we are going to implement. See, is it possible for us? Are you cooperating? Then these are the benefits. If so, we can go ahead to implement the blockchain. Like that, we have to take the decision of the implementation of the blockchain. Then what is the feasibility? Once you implement the blockchain, you have taken the decision to implement the blockchain. So what is the feasibility? Evaluation, we have to see. Suitable business process to transform into blockchain. Okay. So you have to identify which business process is being very much complex in your business and try to convert that business process into blockchain. Because we have to save the money, we have to save the cost, we have to give the transparency and everything. So whichever end-to-end business process is useful for us, that has to be considered into the blockchain transformation. And stakeholders in that business process and existing followed business technology, what are the technologies and how we are doing that existing, what technologies we are using, either manually we are doing or something, and existing operational expenditures, what is the expenditure we are incurring as of now, what are the unnecessary expenditures, and what are the period, one business cycle. Suppose you are doing like that, one business cycle, when you are getting the paddy and you are doing milling it and getting made, convert into rice and sending it to some dealers and retailers and getting the money again to you. So how much time it is taking? 1 month, 2 months or something like that, that is called the business cycle. So for that one business cycle, you are producing and getting the money back for that after selling. That is the time period, is the one business cycle. So for that business cycle, you have to see how much period it is taking, and what are the investment cost for that also as a working capital for that period, how much you have to hold the money to do that business cycle, and what are the dependencies of intermediaries like that, any banks or something for bill purchasing, so bill discounts, any other payment channels and everything, what are the commissions you are paying for DD purchases or bill discounting, all these unnecessary expenditures. These are all intermediaries. So we can avoid all those things. So we have to evaluate all these feasibilities when we are going for the blockchain implementation before taking a decision with all our stakeholders. See the feasibility. We have to put, I am comfortable in calculating all these things and suggest the things. So if anybody interests, you can consult or call me. No problem. Anytime I will tell you. And what is the blockchain data with safety? So the blockchain data, what Hrishikesh has told as a technology side, there are financial transactions, non-financial transactions. As of now, we are talking about the non-financial transactions. So blockchain data, suppose here I have taken this one, like this is oranges or something, where we are producing the oranges in farm, and that farm has been, and it has been processed, and what are the temperature, soil and everything in that farm, and where it is located in the geographical area, and what is the how it has been processed after plucking and everything, and how it has been shipped to the stores and everything, and how this has been distributed to the retail and everything. Like that, everything process, in the process we have implemented this for that business in the blockchain. So all the data, in all phases of the data, has been updated in the blockchain database. Here, so many places, most of the IoT will be involved. Okay, so many data like temperatures and controls and sensors will put, and what is the store temperature, what is the truck temperature inside of the box of the oranges when it is shipping, and what is the shelf life. All these things will be collected, the data will be collected in the real time, and it will be updated in the blockchain. One case study with respect to the food processing. This is the food processing ecosystem. I told that the blockchain technology is one of the technologies, participation of all the stakeholders. So in this ecosystem, there are many activities will be there. So the participants in the food processing ecosystem, for example, I have taken this, one is the fruits, another one is poultry, another one is fisheries. So most of these things, the remaining cycle will be common, but the major segment will be different initially. And once we have filled the farms and everything in the either fruit or poultry or fishing or something, then we have to culture those things, product, and it will be shipped to the storage units. When we are processing that in farming, we will get all the data of that product, like a hen or food or fish, through sensors and everything, whatever the data available, and it will be updated in the blockchain, and that will be shipped to the processing storage units. In that storage units, what is the climate conditions, humidity, temperature, and what is the, how much time it has been stored in that storage unit, all the data will be updated in the blockchain. What the data also will be updated through IoT sensors. We will get those data and we can update into the blockchains. And when the next, it will be sent to the food processing units. When the there also, we have to see what are the hygienic factors and what are the procedures they are following. All the data will be updated in the blockchain, and from there, and food manufacture will be there, and from there, manufacturing industry will be like a packing, and it will put in the cans or tins or packing in the polythene covers like that. All the manufacturers' standards will be updated in the blockchain. And what are the procedures and temperatures and quality of food and nutrition levels, and everything will be updated with respect, tested, quality will be tested, nutrition levels, and everything will be updated in the blockchain from the food manufacturer. And from there, it will be shipped to the distributor. There, how much time it has been traveled and everything, that will also be updated. And it will be again to the retailer or some homes and a delivery to home, like that. So entire cycle will be recorded, transaction activities will be recorded in the food processing. So the entire transparency will be there in each and every phase, every stage of the activity in this processing ecosystem. So there is no point of deviation, so there is no point of cheating. So because of the when the product has been received and the product will be labeled with some data, with RFID data, some label will be there, QR code will be there on the product. If you scan the QR code on the product, it will tell all the history of the product from the origin of this product. So like that, the customer will have total clarity of the product, whether it is good product or not, and whether it has met the standards and everything, food safety and everything will be available. So this is the food processing ecosystem. What I told is, getting the paddy or something from fields, and it will go to the storage, your FCA godowns or something, and from there food processors and rice mills or something, it will go, and from there food manufacturing, any manufacturer, other manufacturer also will be there, and from there also distribution through lifts, all these things will be there. And from there too, it will go to the retailers, and next it will go to the domestic purpose. So like that, every activity will be recorded in the blockchain. For this, we have to enable every activity to be recorded in the blockchain with getting the updating the data from the each and every node of those activity. Those are all the participants, stakeholders. So when the food safety norms, when we are finding, then this is another case. When we want to buy, suppose we are going to purchase oranges or something. So when oranges, from where it has been cultivated, like that, by whom it was formed, and where it was formed, and when, if the period or month or something, and how it was plucked, and stored, processed, shipped, and delivered, all these things, and all the details, and where the product nutrients and shelf life also, and what is the food safety compliance norms it has been met, whether it is an organic or fertilizer product or basal product or something, and what are the nutrients and what is the health hazards, after consuming and everything, those checklists, and the journey of entire thing we have to verify. We can verify through this. When we scan that that QR code of the product and the shipment, then we can verify all those details in this through food safety norms. So that much comfortableness is there. Now I am going to case study of the seed. So if we are considering the seed to consider as a blockchain, as a one of the facility, what is to be done? Now I have prepared some of the ecosystem. Most of the thing I have covered, I think. If experts are there before me, if I any missed or something, please let me know. So most of the seed producers will be there, and the seed producers may be the government recognized people and government authorized persons, or any other from, if the seed is not available in our country, maybe from other countries also, from authorized organizations, government sponsored organizations, and fertilizer companies, and pesticide companies, and labor inputs and machine suppliers like tractor manufacturers, all these people, and millers and grading units and storage units, like warehouses, godowns, and marketing yards for sale of the product of the farmer, like transport companies for shipment of the products, and buyers and distributors and retailers and sellers, farmers and procurement people. These are most of the people or the stakeholders in this ecosystem. Some of them may be involved, some of them as per the requirement of the business process, some of them may not. These are seed blockchain stakeholders, so what are in the pictorial I have put. This is the initially we have put the seed, identify the seed and grading that and collecting it and putting it to the warehouses, and we have to check the quality, whether germination also properly done or not, and what is the grading and any full life size quality of the seed is there or not or something. Manually they will check and the randomly or something, and some ginning activities also they will do. After once the seed is confirmed is good for distribution or something, and then automatically it will be shipped to the farmers or retailers. And in this I could not mention some of the government activities and the subsidies or something, where we are giving the subsidy to the farmers and everything in the remote areas like Jammu and Kashmir, Guwahati, or like that. Some people you will give some discount with respect to some transport charges or like that. I think may not be I have covered, but I am mentioning. This is the total. Actually, I have covered this most of the processes oriented where we can adapt and how this can be converted into the transformation. See here, what the seed blockchain stakeholders, where our Indian government has given the supply chain activities, how this total network and what you have mentioned from the this seed generation and everything. All the data will be covered and updated in the blockchain. We can integrate this seed supply chain data. You have the MIS for this. If we implement this blockchain in the agriculture department, these MIS data and everything can be linked to the blockchain. So all the data will be updated, real-time data, whatever you have existing data can be linked to the blockchain. Automatically, most of the 90% of data will be updated, available in the through blockchain. The most of the transparency will be there. So here, government seed supply chain, what I have mentioned is some of those activities, those seed research, produce and processing and supplying and distribution. These are the main activities, and seed buyers, farmers and other companies, these are all. So as per this seed blockchain stakeholders supply chain, we can complete the blockchain activity through this, integrating this. Certification is also there. Yeah. Everything, whatever the activities will be here by the government, whatever they're doing through MIS and everything, all data can be stored in the blockchain. It can be referred and it will be used for the reference for the certifications and everything. So there I have mentioned for that. When you have purchased the seed also, then your seed bags also will be tagged with whatever the QR code and everything. There also I have not mentioned in this one. There also in the bags also, that if you scan the QR code everything, the data will be available to the farmer to have total history of the seed. And the farmers' data also will be integrated to the blockchain. Here I have not mentioned that farmers also can be enabled with the mobile application. Okay, all the farmers can interact with this blockchain through mobile application. Through mobile application, all farmers can be registered in this one, and whatever the through Aadhaar and everything, whatever the their land records also, and their expenditure records also. Every year, the how much they are doing expenditure, how much return they are doing, getting, and what are the better benefits in the next year and next crop, and what is the seed required for the next crop also, they can put indent in this. Basing on that indents, that will updated in the blockchain. That records will be there of your this previous one. See, in this one, so in this MIS you will get all the data, whereas you are also getting the data from the field distributors and everything, agriculture departments. That data also from the farmers also you will get direct feedback. So you will be ready with from which area and what kind of crop seed will be in the demand for the next season. That also you will be ready with that. That one, and you can make the initiations for the breeding and everything for that. So that kind of entire gamut of this thing will can be covered in this blockchain activity. Very very useful and very very comfortable way. So if this blockchain can be implemented in the massive ways, then only it will be useful, because big companies can introduce implement this blockchain for their purpose internally or something, or some allied companies. But suppose if the government company, government Telangana or Andhra Pradesh or whatever it may be, if they can collaborate with company or something to do the implement of this blockchain and everything, we can evaluate this, what are the feasibilities and how can do all these things, the proposal we can propose, and that we can take it forward to your higher levels and you can propose that. So that kind of, because the government agencies, the governments can afford this cost of expenditure to implement this blockchain without any hesitation for the benefit of the country. So that is the advantage. Transparency will be there, trust will be there, all of the benefits, all benefits are there. Now I am going to give some case study on just a simple poultry farming. This is one of the poultry farming in this, the chicken on blockchain. Suppose when you are doing the chicken farming, the poultry farming, the chicken, you carefully observe that the chicken leg has been, ankle has been tagged with RFID tag. So when it was born or something, as a chick or something, then we will tag, put a tag to its leg, and we will make it as a one asset, and we will record all the data of this, that chicken hen. We have to implement some technologies through IoT, blockchain, artificial intelligence and machine learning for further improvement analytics of the data, and how this has been chicken has been in the blockchain. That I have mentioned something with respect to that, and the farming of the poultry is a very healthy one, and chicken ankles with RFID tags I have put, and I will record all the activities, how much feed it is consuming, what are the vaccines it is taking, and what is the activity, daily activity, whether it is sitting ideally somewhere itself in the corner of the cage or something, or whether it is moving around all the way, all the night or all the hours or something, and what is the behavior of the chicken, and what is the weight, what is the food it is consuming, whether it is growing as per the weight or unnecessarily it is eating. Generally in the poultry, after 2.5 months or something, whatever the feed you give, it will not give any improvement in its weight. Unnecessarily your feed cost will be so generally the poultry farmer will try to push up this hen before to that due date, otherwise he will not get any profit on that. So that's why we have to see the weight and everything and all these aspects. See, all once it has been completed, then how it has been processed or dressed and in the dressing room, and how it has been packed, and what are the precautions has been taken in the packing and everything, whether it is hygienic and everything, and how it has been shipped to the stores and everything, retail purpose, and all these things, all activities has been updated in the blockchain. You have to bear, if you want, you are paying money for the medical and everything, right? Instead of that, you pay here. very nominal expenditure. So when you are doing in a massive way, it will not be costly, right? So automatically it will become very cheap. So because nobody is introducing and nobody is caring of this one, that's why these people are saying that it is costly, costly, costly. Once it has been implemented in this blockchain, it will not be only for you. You can invite other business people also be part of in this blockchain. They can utilize it. Huge space. It will not be restricted to only your business only. You can adapt so many other business people also to into this one, participate in this blockchain. They will also utilize this network. So that flexibility is there. So automatically your cost of investments will become less. So these are the real activities I have put for you all. Thank you, gentlemen.